So a quick overview of vectors. A vector has both magnitude and direction. So it has both magnitude and direction, usually represented with a lowercase letter and an arrow over it. Okay. A vector opposite vector A. So a negative vector is the same as vector A, but in the opposite direction. The absolute value of vector A means the magnitude only. An important thing to note is if I'm talking about a navigation problem, this is north, south, west, east. This is 0 degrees, 90, 180. I go clockwise off in north in navigation. If there's no notation at all on there, then it's counterclockwise off of x. So this is counterclockwise. So now I'm going to kind of put all that into play in a problem, number 5 in section 5.7. So in 5.7, my first vector is 11 units north. So my first vector, my first vector is 11 units due north. So that's vector A, followed by a second vector at a bearing of 70 degrees. So my first vector A is 11 units due north. My second vector B is 5 units at 70 degrees, but this is a bearing, meaning I'm going clockwise off of north. So my second vector is this one right here. It's 5 units long, and it's 70 degrees off of north. And then I'm going to add these two vectors together with the tail of tip method. So I transpose vector B up here. It's 5 units long. If this is 70, this interior angle is 110 degrees. It's a supplement of 70. Then my resultant vector goes from the tail of the first to the tip of the second. And I'm going to call that R for resultant, meaning I'm going to add the two together. So then I'm going to use the law of cosines. R squared equals 5 squared plus 11 squared minus 2, 5, 11, cosine of the angle opposite R, cosine of 110 degrees. Square root of 183 is 13.5. So this length right here is 13.5. Does that even look right? Largest angle, longest side. It's still not a vector. I need to find an angle. So now I'm going to find this angle here. I'll call it theta. So I'm going to say sine of 110 degrees over the side opposite it, 13.5, is equal to sine of theta over the side opposite, 5. One ratio equal to another, proportion, I cross multiply. I solve for theta here, and theta is equal to 20.4 degrees. So this angle right here is 20.4 degrees, and I also need an answer off of due north. So this angle is that angle in the triangle, but it's also how far I am off of north. So my solution for vector A plus vector B is 13.5 units at an angle of 20.4 degrees. And I have to let the reader know it's a bearing off of north, so I put on there northeast. Okay. Any questions? Please subtract those two vectors. So the first vector was A, 11 units at an angle of 0 degrees due north. The second vector B was 5 units at an angle of 70 degrees, and 70 is into the northeast. Now I want to subtract these vectors. So I'm going to draw vector A first. It's 11 units long going due north. Vector B is right here, 5 units long at an angle of 70. So here's, if this is B, this is negative B. Still 5 units long, but in the opposite direction. So I'm going to transpose negative B up here. It's 5 units long. My resultant vector goes from the tail of the first to the tip of the second, but I have to figure out this angle here. So if this is 20 degrees, this would be 20 degrees. Everybody follow that? This is 70. This is its complement at 20. So this is 70, its complement at 20. So it's 20 degrees below horizontal. So if that's horizontal, this would be 20, and this would be 70. So my resultant vector of A minus B is this vector here. And I'm going to say that vector A minus B squared is equal to one leg squared plus the other leg squared minus 2, 1, the other cosine, the angle opposite the side, cosine is 70 degrees. Let me do that on my calculator. Square root of 108. So A minus B, vector A minus vector B is equal to 10.4. So this is 10.4 units long. And that looks right because it's opposite 70 degrees. Now I have to find an angle. I'm going to find this angle here, theta. I'm going to use the law of cosines to find that angle theta. So I'm going to take the side opposite it, 5 squared equals 1 leg squared, the other leg squared minus 2, 1 leg, the other cosine of theta. So cosine of theta equals 0.89. I take the arc cosine of both sides. And this angle theta works out to be 27 degrees. So this is 27 degrees right here. So my answer of A minus B is 10.4 units at an angle of, well, if it's 27 this direction, it has to be 333 off the north. 333 degrees plus 27 gives me 360. So it's 333 degrees into the northwest. So that's how I do A minus B. Problem's given is a bearing off of north. My answer is a bearing off of north.